The month of June is dedicated to the ocean, and as the UNCTAD Special Advisor for the Blue Economy, it is my pleasure to join this debate on how data can answer the global call to make peace with our blue planet. Because today humanity is out of balance with nature, in conflict with our fellow species, with our climate, and with our ocean. But what gives me hope is that there is a growing, passionate movement for change uniting citizens, countries, organizations, companies, CEOs, scientists, and politicians. The problems we face are complex, interconnected, and evolving, and you cannot change what you do not understand. Good data, science, and artificial intelligence can enhance analysis and understanding, and leads to better decision-making, better governance, and better outcomes for a blue planet. Accurate data not only contributes to making peace with nature, it is absolutely essential. As a sailor, I've witnessed the declining health of our ocean. As a philanthropist, I know how important it is for governments, the private sector, and local communities to work together and invest in science-based decision-making and technologies that can transform ocean protection and empower people to make peace with the ocean. The challenge is as vast as the ocean itself. As we embark on the UN Decade for Ocean Science, marine resources and biodiversity continue to be plundered by overfishing, polluted by industry and agriculture, and threatened by climate change. The overall value of the ocean as an asset is higher than the UNCTAD's estimate of an annual $2.5 trillion of tradable ocean-based goods and services. With 3 billion people dependent on healthy ocean for their food and livelihoods, we need to better understand our relationship with the ocean. If we are to achieve a sustainable and regenerative blue economy, we need to change how we value the ocean's biodiversity while still alive, how we trade, how we change our patterns of consumption and production, as well as our food and transport systems. We must work together across all sectors to advance data-driven research and make it accessible, to help close the technology gap between North and South, and to inform good policy making. The Bertrand Foundation Marine Science Program advances understanding of the critical role of large marine protected areas. It is pushing boundaries through innovation, capacity building, and generating the best science and data, validating the importance of large MPAs for ocean life and climate resilience, both within and beyond their borders. The Pew Bertorelli Ocean Legacy Project encourages better marine spatial planning, designation, and implementation of MPAs through research and technology such as satellite and remote sensing or eDNA analysis of seawater samples. But to realize the potential of MPAs, these must be enforced, and that requires investment and innovation in data collection and analysis. So it was only logical that I should partner with Global Fishing Watch to found Marine Manager. It is a first-of-its-kind technology portal that provides interactive ocean data in near real-time in an easy-to-use interface for free. It allows users to track vessels involved in fishing, tourism, oil drilling, and shipping, and overlay this with oceanographic and ecological datasets to see the impact of human pressures and climate change on their MPA and its biodiversity. The portal is being trialed in 5 sites: Palau, Ascension, Guyana, Niue, and the Galapagos, and is fully scalable. This portal puts data at the fingertips of policymakers, managers, and communities, giving them the power to make informed decisions and manage huge ocean areas more effectively. Data and science empower, unite, motivate, and accelerate change, and can drive progress towards global goals for the ocean, for climate change, and for the protection of our planet. The world needs to invest in new ways to harness technology and innovation, including artificial intelligence, to make information accessible and actionable. Fish know no borders, and neither should science or global commitments to achieve peace with nature for a sustainable future for all.